Get ready to match the stars. Edward Asner, Brett Summers, Gary Berghoff, Marcia Rahn, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rivers!
Thank you all. Now, let's have some...
Yes.
Just wanted to say a brief word of greeting to our regulars, Brett Summers, of course.
Hello.
And Gary Berghoff is a kind of a semi-regular. Charles Nelson Reilly couldn't be with us today.
I'm just standing in for Charles.
No, but we're lucky to have you.
The tallest I've been in years.
And we're lucky to have you too, sir.
I'm not surprised.
And there's another lady who's here as often as we can get her.
You think you're lucky to have had him?
Oh, dear me.
And she you've had.
I didn't say...
Watch
it. I didn't say MASH when I talked to you. I should have said that.
Oh, nice.
You didn't say Mary Tyler Moore.
Oh, I didn't say Mary Tyler Moore when I talked to you.
You didn't say Mary Tyler Moore.
You didn't say the dumplings when you're going to talk to her.
And you didn't say Match Game 76 for Brett Summers.
No, I didn't say that. And I didn't say Mary Tyler Moore. You don't look like Mary Tyler Moore.
No. Well, I dance that way.
And now the dumplings of Marcia Rahn. She comes to us directly from the dumplings.
Directly. Wow.
Yeah.
I'm inspired by your suit.
Thank you. Now, Lila Healy and Steve Holtrust, welcome.
Let's find out a little bit about these two people. Shall we do that? Beginning with you, Steve.
Well, I'm a newlywed. I've been married for just over a month. Got a beautiful wife sitting right down there.
Really?
And I'm a fireman for the city of Ontario.
Now, let's find out about Lila.
Well, I'm originally from Hawaii. And now I live in Simi Valley. I'm married to a wonderful man who's in the audience. I have a daughter, Tan. I work as a waitress in Woodland Hills.
And you have a nice smile.
Thank you.
Okay. Good luck to both of you. May I remind you that you'll be trying to match as many of our contestants as you can. And the winner will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000. There we go. Now, Steve, I'll ask you to make a selection. Do you want A or B?
I'd like A, please.
A it is. Here we go, folks. Last night. Betty White.
Oh.
Dreamed she was preparing the world's largest trout. And when she woke up, Betty discovered she was trying to blank Alan Ludden.
Okay.
Did you write something on the card?
What?
Write something on the card. Would turn up her hearing aid.
I got it, honey.
See, you got a softball. What do you?
Why do they call you Honest John?
Here we go. Well, yes.
Because of your pool cues.
Write something on the card. Yes, I wanted someone to write
something.
I have
to say in front, I'm not crazy about that.
Okay. Now she's finished. We'll come to Steve. Last night, Steve, Betty dreamed she was preparing the world's largest trout. And when she woke up, she discovered she was trying to blank Alan Ludden.
Filet.
Filet?
But he had his fill.
You know, when I read this, I thought, well, for that, but filet never crossed my mind.
Filet hard, but filet clean.
Yeah.
What?
I think it didn't cross my mind.
Didn't cross your mind either.
No, because I think there's nothing better than
stuffed Alan Ludden. Yeah, just trying to stuff Alan Ludden. There. That's a picture. What do you say?
Are you happily married? Oh, ooh. Darn. I said, because I love his answer. It's cute. I didn't say that. I said she was trying to put a hook in him.
Put a hook in him. Well,
Is that right?
Yes. We'll find out later.
Steve,
Gary?
Steve is absolutely right. She wasn't trying to fillet Alan Ludden.
No.
She was trying to fillet, but she was trying to stuff him and hang him on the wall is what she was doing. And I
stuff him on the wall. I see. I see. Yes. Like a trophy on the wall, Blair.
Uh-huh.
So what do you say, Marcia?
Well, Jean, I thought perhaps she was trying to scale Alan Ludden.
Scale him.
Scale. As in Mount Everest.
Yes.
Scale as in Mount Everest.
Oh, song, climb every mountain. Yes. Very true.
He woke up, she discovered she was trying to blank Alan Ludden, and Steve said fillet.
What's a great answer? I said stuff.
Stuff seems to be the route they're going there. Stuff. Now, tell us the truth, Betty, about this situation.
Yes, but stuff in the sense of a gourmet cook. The other would be to mount. This is to stuff.
Right. Of course. Yes. Okay. All right. Yes, of course. Now we've got one for you, Lila. Are you ready for us?
Yes.
We're ready for you, honey. The prisoner said, when this warden uses the thumb screw on you, it really hurts because he doesn't screw it on your thumb, he screws it on your plane. That's why it hurts. Hello there.
Hi,
Now we're waiting for Brett. Gary, Brett's ready. And here comes Gary. So we come over here to Lila. Okay. The prisoner said, when this warden uses the thumb screw on you, it really hurts because he doesn't screw it on your thumb, he screws it on your blank.
Bottom.
Okay, she said bottom.
Tongue?
She said bottom.
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 That's a big thumb screw.
That's right.
In my case, anyway.
Yes.
As I said before, this show has been so broadening for me that the new lexicon of words I have picked up here, that he screws it on his wah-wah.
Why does he keep...
I keep telling you, there is no such word. What do you say?
Oh, honey, I said, well, this could be a match. I said navel. It's just the other side of... Well, don't be so hateful.
Close there. No match there. Now, Gary...
Just a little above the navel is the nose.
Is the nose. Okay. Lila's looking for the answer. Bottom. He screws it on your bottom. What do you say, Marcia?
Well, I matched Gary with nose.
Two noses so far. Richard, what do you offer here?
Pray the nose have it.
The nose have it. Is that true, Betty? Do the nose have it?
Well, now, if this fellow were all thumbs, it wouldn't matter what we said. I said his tongue.
Score. That would hurt. Mm. So there's the end of round one, and we have no score, but round two is going to get worse. So tune in, see what happens. Now we go to round two. And, Steve, since you went first last time, Lila will go first this time, and we ask you to make a selection.
A.
All right, Lila. It's all yours. Everybody plays. Dr. Quacko said to the patient, I will take out your appendix for free. However, it'll cost you $500 if you want blank.
Oh, I got it.
Take out your appendix for free. However, it'll cost you $500 if you want blank.
Oh, just
you fill
took
in that
a
blank.
Second.
All right. Close enough. Lila. Dr. Quacko said to the patient, I'll take out your appendix for free. However, it'll cost you $500 if you want blank. What were you doing all that time we were fiddling around over there? Weren't you thinking?
Yes, but I'm blank.
You drew a blank. Now just think about this. Hello there.
Hi, Lila.
Oh, if you want it, bronze.
If you want a bronzed appendix.
Yeah.
Isn't she cute? She really blows the whole thing in a very charming way, doesn't she? Okay. $500 if you want a bronzed appendix.
I wish I'd said it.
Really? Yes.
Yeah. But I figure that it was one of those rotten doctors.
No, I took a peek at your answer.
Yes.
And you came up with a terrific answer. Listen to a terrific answer, Lila.
He didn't charge anything to take it out, but he charged $500 to be sewed up.
There's an answer. See?
Free to take it out. However, if you want me to sew you up afterwards, it'll be $500. Now, isn't that clever of him?
Are you going to repeat that accolade? I did hit my answer before he did his.
Oh, you did?
Stitches.
Oh, that is a terrific answer. You're going to put me in stitches. What?
Those are very good answers.
Yes, they are.
Well, I don't know. I don't think it's a very good sales pitch. Any dum-dum can sew, but not too many people can have
not
their appendix
dumb-dumb.
Without anesthesia.
Anesthesia. That would hurt if you did it without them. Is that what you say?
Well, I was thinking of saying for the hospital room, but I said, badly spelled, chloroform.
Chloroform. All right.
She has Phyllis.
We got, nothing is happening here with Lila and with Steve here. Dr.
Well, maybe
Quintus
if
of the
you
patient.
Had spoken to her in her native tongue and said, mahalo, which is thank you, isn't it, and please, she still would
mahalo?
Have said
mahalo. Yes. Did I say mahalo?
No, mahalo is thank you.
Mahalo is thank you.
Right.
Oh, all right.
Right. Now ask her again. Maybe she'll change her mind. If she's smart, she'll say stitches.
The die is cast.
Oh, it is cast.
They say. Yeah. For free, $500 if you want...
Stitches.
Stitches. Yeah.
Mahalo.
Mahalo. Now, what did you say?
Milky, milky. I had just the so-so answer, stitches.
Stitches.
Oh, yeah.
So-so
answer. I'm ashamed of you,
stitches
Betty.
Stitches would have done very well for you there.
So-so.
Are you ready, Steve? You know what position you're in now. All you have to do is match one of the dingbats, and you've won the game. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, here it is. Fu Manchu said,
yes.
He said, once every year on my honorable birthday.
Oh, just a second.
What?
He did not speak like Lawrence Welk. I'll either do an Oriental gentleman or an English.
Wonderful, wonderful. No, once every year on my honorable birthday.
Yeah.
Honorable geisha girl brinks my honorable feet.
Oh.
What?
Would you like me to translate?
You better
all right, the translation. Fu Manchu said, once every year, on my honorable birthday, honorable geisha girl blanks my honorable feet.
Be much better in English.
No, you don't like it, huh? Oh, who asked you? All right. Little debris must be neat here.
Something.
Yeah. Okay, we're all set, and we come over here to Steve. Fu Manchu said, once every year on my honorable birthday, honorable geisha girl branks my honorable feet.
Bows at my honorable feet.
Steve.
Yes.
Quickly, ask him mahalo.
Yeah, now. I know what's going to happen here.
From the film
we're
going to
get a zip tie here, so okay. We got to zip along here. All right, Edward, go.
Well, this was a very sweet geisha girl, and he did a lot of gumshoeing, Fu Manchu did, so she
shot resoles. All right, Brett. Resoles.
Washes.
Gary.
This is an ancient Chinese custom. They break their feet.
Honorable geisha girl brinks my honorable feet.
Manicures.
Manicures.
Kisses.
Well, kiss my foot.
Which may be a match because you cannot do it standing up. You have to bow down to kiss honorable feet.
No. Nice try,
though.
Not
at kneeling, that's right.
Okay, so we do indeed end up in a tie, and I'll tell you what happens when we do have a tie right after this. Well, friends, we have a tie, so we have to erase the big scores that we've accumulated. Push the button, reveal one tiebreaker for each, and one who scores the most will be the winner. And Steve, you will go first and make a selection.
Did so well on A last time, I think I'd like to try it again.
All right.
Why did you didn't choose C?
Yeah. Phil asked the waiter, is the tongue fresh? And the waiter said, mister, the tongue is so fresh, it'll blank you. Okay, three people are finished. Okay, four, five. All right, Gary, put it in the slot. Now we come over here to Steve. Phil asked the waiter, is the tongue fresh? And the waiter said, mister, the tongue is so fresh, it'll blank you.
French kiss you.
He said, French kiss. That's right, from Bowdown. All right, I don't know. Ed, what'd he say?
Tongue is so fresh it'll blank you. He said French kiss.
What's that mean, French kiss?
It's something we used to do in high school years ago.
I never did it in high school.
Yeah, all right, show us your card.
I taught normal English lick.
Just lick, that's what tongues do. Yes, ma'am.
Well, honey, you know I've always been verbal. I said it was so fresh it would talk to you.
Okay. Gary?
Well, I didn't know it was a foreign restaurant. I said lick.
Okay. So, Steve, there it is. Mr. Tongue is so fresh, it'll French kiss you, according to him. What are you calling you?
Lick.
You said lick there.
This will probably throw you completely. Kiss.
Kiss!
Kiss!
Oh, wait a minute. Thank you. What do you say, my dear?
I said insult you.
Insult you.
That's how fresh that tongue is.
Okay, Steve has one, Lila. You need two. Did you understand?
I understand.
That's not asking too much.
Two comes after one, you see.
Right.
The groom was so absent-minded, he left his bride... thank you, but we're a little short. He left his bride at the reception and spent the wedding night with the blank.
Got it.
The groom was so absent-minded, he left his bride at the reception and spent the wedding night with the blank.
How absent-minded was he?
Are you ready?
Yes.
The groom was so absent-minded, he left his bride at the reception and spent the wedding night with the...
mother-in-law.
Okay, folks. I'll explain to you in a moment what we have when we have a tie and the tiebreaker. Go ahead, Ed.
Well, I always, sexual position of the groom was always a little questionable, so we're not sure if he was absent-minded or not. He spent it with
the best man. Okay, Brett.
And from what I understand, he wasn't the least bit unhappy about it either. The best man.
The best man. And Gary?
He was also absent-minded.
Oh, that's right. All right, Lila is looking for the answer. Mother-in-law. One mother-in-law.
Best man.
Three, four. Best man. Richard?
Second best man.
Second best man. You got a match, Betty?
And the bride was sorry he ever got married. Best man.
So, Steve wins again. Come on, Steve. Congratulations. Now, you stand by there for a moment or so. We got to talk to Lila. It was a pleasure meeting you. We've got some gifts for you, together with our thanks for being with us at Match Game PM. Lila Healy. Now, Steve, you got a chance to win a whole bundle of money here. It's time now for the Big Money Super Match, and we've got two audience matches for you here. And I want to remind you, whatever you match here, you'll have a chance, whatever you earn here, will have a chance to multiply by 10. And let's begin. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Jim Blank. Now, the answer that group gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match next year, you get $250. And the bottom one gets you $100. Now, whom do you call on here for a little assist?
Richard, please.
Jim Dandy.
Jim Dandy. All right.
And Betty?
What do you say?
Jim Garner.
Jim Garner. Okay.
And Brett.
How about Jim Neighbors?
Jim Neighbors. Of course. Naturally. Your Jim Neighbors, Jim Dandy, and Jim Garner. You want one of those? You may have a better idea.
I think I'll go with Jim Dandy.
Jim Dandy, that's the one that Richard gave you. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $100 response, please? Jim Dandy it is, right off the bat, you got it. What is under the 250? Slide it, Earl. Jim Neighbors is there, that was suggested. Jim Beam?
Jim Beam.
Call it.
Will the winos please be silent? Slide it, Earl. Oh, you're right. Winos of the world, unite! Okay, you've won $100, which means that the least you'll be playing for is $1,000. Now we're going to see how much more you can win with the second audience match. All right, Earl, let's see what it is. Follow blank. Follow blank.
Okay, I think I'll go with Gary this time.
Follow the leader.
Follow the leader's guide.
And Edward?
Ed. Me. Follow me.
And Martha.
Follow up?
Follow up. So those are the three. Follow up, follow me, and follow the leader. You want one?
I think I'll go with follow the leader.
Follow the leader. He says that's going to be up there, way up on top. But as usual, we'll begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick
Very
road.
Artistic group we had here.
Straight to the gym.
Let's see if follow the leaders under the $250 response. Follow me is Ed's answer. Last chance for follow the leader. Here is the $500 number. You've got it. Congratulations to you. Now, you want another $500? We multiply that by 10, which means 5,000. Add that to the previous 1,000, you got a pot of $6,000 to shoot for. Now, to collect the 6,000, you've got to match one of our celebrities exactly head-to-head. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Richard, get ready to write, and you're going to face me. Stand right there, okay? And get your thought waves going over and transfer them to Richard's head and see if you can come up with the same answer on this. Blank pepper. Blank pepper. Blank pepper. I'll give you all the accents. All right, he's finished. Steve Holtrust, give us an answer which will match Richard Dawson's. What do you say, blank pepper?
Salt and pepper.
Salt and pepper. All right. Turn around and face your accuser. He says salt and pepper will match you. Richard, what do you say?
Who gave you the kiss that got you up here? Don't attempt to kiss me now. Salt.
Kiss him, go ahead and kiss him.
No, that's right.
How do you feel?
Feel good.
Terrific. He feels good. Okay. Watch this message and come right back. Join us next week for Match Game BM. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive from Feathers, the rotary powered pickup, the powerful room air conditioner, so lightweight you want to take it everywhere you go. And Hanes Fashion Underwear gives you the fit, the fabrics, the colors, and the styles of the day, all under Hanes Company. And a supply of DuPont Lucite paint to beautify and protect your home. Long-lasting DuPont Lucite. If you go home with the good stuff, and to beautify and protect car upholstery and vinyl tops, use Rally Vinyl Care products from DuPont. And for a smooth running car, Castrol GTX Motor Oil for all models and sizes of cars, Castrol Lubrication for cars, motorcycles, and snowmobiles. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM. A Mark Goodson, Bill Sodnan production. We'll be right back.